grinding, bro. Grinding, bro. I've been collecting for 5 years. I feel like I know I got a little bit of information, bro. Because I've been doing this for 5 years. Number one, you gotta make sacrifices to save your money. Bro, you may not be able to go to the movie theaters that day and pay that $20. You can't go out to eat with them and pay that $20. Maybe you can't go to the fair with them and pay that $20. But that's just $60 in your pocket, G. That's $60 in your pocket, G. You feel me? You just gotta save your money, bruh. Save your money. Make sacrifices. Me, because I started collecting, I didn't have no job, bruh. So every little bit of money was going towards those shoes, bruh. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't paying for no school lunch, bruh. I'd always make it. Save that $5. At the end of the week, I have $25. You feel me? Go grind up, grind up, grind up. Maybe buy a dollar pizza. In 2 weeks, I have $50. You feel me? Keep on doing that. You feel me? 1 month, $100. You feel me? A month, $100. Bro, if I could do it, bro, you could do it. It's really not that hard. You just gotta have discipline. Save your money. Make sacrifices. Like, bro, at most, if I went out, I'd get me a freaking junior chicken meal. At most. But guess what? At the end of 2 months, I'm stepping out in the newest J's. Psych, I'm not. But I was stepping in some J's, bruh. You can find it at affordable prices. I'm gonna show y'all. Number two, don't buy from retail stores. You feel me? If you got it, like right now, I can go to Foot Locker. I can go cop a pair of J's because I have a job, right? But if you're just starting out your collection, don't go to Foot Locker, bro. Don't go there. You know why? Because everybody goes there. Everybody has those, bro. Right? You can't go to Foot Locker and buy these, right? You can't go there. You can't go to Foot Locker and buy these. You feel me? You can't go to Foot Locker and buy these. You know what I mean? You gotta go shop elsewhere. If you want to have the same shoes as everybody, go ahead. But me, I didn't. I hate that, bro. I don't like saving up for a pair of shoes that someone else can just go and buy. You know what I mean? So me personally, I suggest don't go to Foot Locker. Plus they be taxing. They want like $260 for a pair of J's, bro. Come on, come on. I can buy it for way cheaper. I know how to. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Number three, have patience, bruh. Like I said, I've been doing this for 5 years. I started this my 9th grade year of high school. I'm now a freshman in university, bruh. 5 years collecting this stuff, bro. 5 years. This stuff did not come overnight, bro. I promise you that. Yes, it cost 10 bands, but I spent 5 years trying to get that collection, bro. It did not come overnight. And then also, bro, you can obviously go spend 10 bands and get you a collection overnight. You can. You can do it. It's possible. But then where's the affordability in that? Come on. We don't have 10. No one has 10 bands like that. I'm 18, bro. I started this when I was 13. There's no way I was having 10 bands, bro. I had to stack it up. Just had to stack it up. I know what you're saying, bro. Damn, 10 bands? You could have bought a car. I got a car. You feel me? But it's just something I love to do, bro. So when people talk about, oh, it's a waste of money, why would you spend all your money on shoes? First off, I don't spend all my money on shoes, bro. I save like 80% of my money. And like the 20%, I stack it up and I go buy some new shoes, bro. It's just a passion, bro. I've been doing this for so long. Why not, bro? Like, why not? Why are you trying to stop me? Because you got some beat forces? That's why you mad? Number four, shop at your freaking used market. So go to your Kijijis, go to your eBay, go to your Facebook marketplaces. Those are the best places to shop. But you can get $100 Jordan, maybe worn once or twice. $100, bro. $100. Bro, I got these for $75, bro. I got them for $75. You will save money if you buy maybe 9 out of 10 sneakers. Worn once, worn twice. You will get so many shoes on the low because of that. That's my secret. You go to Foot Locker, how much you spend? $260? Almost $3? You go to eBay, Kijiji, Facebook Marketplace. You can buy up to 3 pairs. They was just worn a little bit. And also, most of the time, they're shoes that you will not be able to find at freaking Foot Locker because since they're used, it might be years old. These is from my I think 2007. I'm pretty sure these are from 2007, 2008. You think I was going to Foot Locker when I was 6? No, but look, I got these now. You feel me? So you can really go crazy. I got these for 2 something. I forgot, bro. I got so many. I got these for like 2 something. These go for over freaking 3 something. You feel me? But they were just used at the bottom. You feel me? So I'm telling y'all, it's the way to go. It's the way to go. Number five, you have your used marketplaces, and then you have like apps and stuff. Go on Grail, go on Bump, go on Poshmark, bro. These places, bro, when I tell you, you can find steals on steals. I bought metallic fives for $50, bro. $50. Obviously, I sold those later. I sold those last year. I don't have no more. But fam, you can get so much steals off these apps, bro. It can be used, worn a couple times. You can even get a beater and fix them. Come on, bro. You can save so much money on these apps, bro. Number six. This is what I was doing. Because I know you're saying 5 years. You got when you started collecting when you was 13. How does them fit? When you buy shoes, if you're a young kid right now, if you're younger, you're gonna grow, buy a size or two up. That's what I did, bro. I was size 9, buying size 10 and a half, 11. And you know what? I made it work, bro. I put extra insoles in it. So it worked when I was that age. I kept them clean and I can use it now. You know what I'm saying? It's real simple. It's real simple. I still got shoes from back then and I can rock them right now. You know why? Because I bought a couple sizes up and now I can enjoy them too. You feel me? That's all it is, bro. Last but not least, always be looking. If you're not even looking for a pair of shoes, always be looking, because you never know when a steal is coming. You never know. For me, I always keep a little cash on the side and I'm always searching, always looking. I won't even plan to be buying sneakers that month. Boom, I'll find a pair, $75. Boom, I'll find a pair, $100. Boom, $50. I'm like, what? You know what I'm saying? Go cop them, you feel me? But you just have to have the mentality, bro. Going back to number one, if you're able to save money, put that aside. Now I have a job, so it's easier. I can just put a little money to the side. But if you could just do that and always be looking for steals, you use these apps, you use these websites, you always looking for steals, you'll get as many shoes as you want, brother. You'll be able to do it. It's really not that hard. The sneaker game, it's all about patience and knowing what to do, bro. This is what I do, because everybody asks me, how am I able to do it? Shoot, it really ain't that hard. Is it hard? Now that you know, it really ain't that hard. But hey, make sure you like, comment, subscribe. Future Bang is coming. You know what I'm saying? It's a little throwaway video because y'all wanted it. But if y'all like the fashion video, the shoe videos, let me know. You feel me? Love y'all. Peace.